congregation was singing a tune in a voice that was loud and clear. You know the crowd that stood around him, they were crying, I could plainly see, for the song that they sang was touching. They were singing, "Near, oh my God,
selection by the new consoles in that order. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I do honor the Spirit of Christ this morning, and I honor the family and the ministers and everyone. I honor you this morning. And before I go into prayer, what is my duty, I like to say I thank God for each one of you. And I had the opportunity to sing with Brother Coombs. Amen. It's smart to say that. Amen. Let us pray. Well, Heavenly Father, in the precious name of Jesus, we come before you, O God, in the most humble way we know how, God. Father God, in both your Holy Spirit here this evening, God, thanking you, O God, for your many blessings, Lord. We thank you for being God and God all by yourself. We thank you for your darling Son, Jesus. And Father God, in times like these, we know you are with us. But Lord, we just want to tell you thank you.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
Thank you for the life of Brother Crumes, God. We thank you for everything, Father. Mm-hmm. And oh God, before I go any further in prayer, I ask forgiveness, Lord, for anything I've said or done. Mm-hmm. Anything that I bring you glory, God. Because, Lord, I want to be with you when I leave this world, God. So, Father God, we want to tell you thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Brother Coons has lived his life. And, oh, God, he's with you, we pray. And, oh, God.
God, I thank you now.
Thank you.
Each and every heart in your building, it's praying time. Yes. And stop playing time. So God, just give us the spirit to keep going in the name of Jesus. Yes. Lord, bless each and every listener here today, each and every representative, God. And we want to tell you thank you.
Thank you, Lord,
for what you're doing right now.
Mm-hmm.
Rest in peace, Brother Crumes. We love you, but God loves you best. In Jesus' name, I pray, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Well, bless the Lord, amen.
Amen.
Thank you for condolences to you all on this. Psalm 139, verses 5 through 10. And it says, Thou hast beset me behind and before, and laid thine hand upon me. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me. It is high. I cannot attain unto it. Whither shall I go from thy spirit? Or whether shall I flee from thy presence? If I ascend up into heaven, thou art there. If I make my bed in hell, behold, thou art there. If I take the wings of the morning and dwell in the uttermost parts of the sea, even there thy hand shall lead me, and thy right hand shall hold me.
Amen.
Amen.
In the honor of the Spirit of Christ to his family, I thank God for you sharing him with us. He was my spiritual guide there, so I thank God for his life. John 14 says, Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself. That where I am, there ye may be also. And where I go, ye know, and the way ye know. Thomas said unto him, Lord, we know not where thou goest, and how can we know the way? Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. The word of God is already with us.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Want to say one more time, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
My wife and I, we are the new consolers. Those of you who remember the old consolers, Brother Pugh, Sister Pugh. Back in the day, I used to travel with them in the packages whenever I sung with the Florence Pensioners. And I was like their godson. And when I left the Florence Pensioners, I played for Swansea Towns and more other groups, and I backed up a whole lot of groups when they needed a bass player. But when I got to sing with the Soul Stirrers, I sang with the Soul Stirrers with Brother Arthur, Brother Leroy, and Justin for 15 years. And I tell you, that's the best group that I ever sung with.
Amen.
He took me up under his wings. He was like a father to me. And he loved to practice every single day. If he wasn't on singing somewhere, he had that guitar just like this. He kept it in his hand all the time, day and night, Brother Crume. And I tell you, we spent so much time together, years and years together, every single day. And this song is called "Around God's Strong." And buddy. Consolers. Y'all remember Ryan God's Throne?
Yeah.
We're going to sing this song, and this is my beautiful wife right here, and we've been married going on 2 years now.
Amen.
And
Amen.
She traveled all over. She won the Stellar Awards in 2018. So God has equipped us to be the new consolers.
Amen.
And so I just want to give God a praise and let you know that just stay strong. And one day, when it's all over, when that rapture comes, and that trumpet, every sign of that trumpet, and the skies open up, the ones that are going to be caught up, and there's one that's sleeping in the air, he's going to say, come on in, welcome, my good and faithful servant. And I believe that he's like my father. I believe he's going to make it easy. And I just pray that we all be ready. We need to be born again.
Amen.
There's no other way for us to make it in the kingdom of heaven. We got to be born again.
Amen.
Give God a hand.
Amen.
In that order.
first resolution, just want to honor the family and tell you that I may not know all of them, but we pray for the one that's connected to me. And you ask God to move on their behalf. Just know that God can reach you right where you are. The New Fellowship Missionary Baptist Church sends a church resolution. God was walking in his garden when he made with his own hands. The sun was shining on each blossom, young and old, throughout all lands. In our church, he walked still searching for a lovely full-grown flower. Finally, pausing here, he found one, ready to be taken at that very hour. Whereas God in his infinite wisdom has called from our midst your beloved brother, Arthur Crume Sr., due to his willingness to serve the Lord in any capacity necessary and living in a life that exemplified Christ. This transition will be deeply felt by the entire Crume family. Whereas we extend to the bereaved family and friends our deepest sympathy while assuring them that our God is too wise to make a mistake. We also say, earth has no sorrow that heaven cannot heal. Be our resolve that God in his infinite wisdom and undying love knows what is best. Because of this, we have learned not to question him, but to lean and depend on him, for all our help comes from the Lord. We know you, the family, will miss Brother Crume. He was active in so many capacities within his church body. Be it further resolved by the membership of the New Fellowship Missionary Baptist Church that we do thank God for permitting us to have one so faithful, willing, and dedicated to work within this Christian family. The memory of Brother Crume's devotion and steadfastness to the church has inspired many of us to a more noble way. Of living and a greater sense of service to the Lord. So, family, know that Brother Crume is now in a better place.
Amen.
No more death, disappointments,
yes.
Heartaches,
amen.
Pain, sickness, or sorrow.
Yes.
For these former things have now passed away.
Yes.
Now, we say, rest from your labor under the trumpet. God shall sound, and the dead that died in the Lord shall rise from their graves,
yes,
to an incorruptible life, and forever be with our God, and all of the saints who have gone on before him. Humbly submitted, December 23rd, 2023, New Fellowship Missionary Baptist Church, Chicago, Illinois, Deacon Robert Williams, Charity. In all thy ways, acknowledge God. Second resolution coming from Chicago Metropolitan Chapter Gospel Music Workshop of America. Resolution of Brother Arthur Lee Crume Sr., December 23rd, 2023. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so shall we ever be with the Lord. 1 Thessalonians 4, chapter 16 and 17 verse. To Sister Deborah Crume Lofton, the bereaved family, and all ecclesia. Whereas the mighty God, in his own way and for his own purpose, has plucked from his garden a gentle spirit once again,
We, the members of the Chicago Metropolitan Chapter of the Gospel Music Workshop of America, bow our heads in humble submission to an all-wise and loving God, who knows and does all things well. We take this time to express our sincere condolences to our dear and faithful member, Sister Deborah Lofton, and the entire family in the homegoing of your beloved father, Brother Arthur Crume Sr. Be it resolved that we thank God for the life of Brother Crume, and let us be reminded that this gentle giant served others during and after his tenure with the world-renowned Soul Stirrers, a pioneer singing group which paved the way in the development of quartet-style gospel music and is known throughout the world. During this bereavement period, we commend you to God's care, for he cares for you. Yes. May these words be of comfort to each of you, for it is written in John 14, 2 and 3, that in my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you, and if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. Brother Crume is now sleeping in that prepared mansion. As referenced in John 14, 2 and 3, we encourage you to stay strong in the Lord and lean not to your own understanding, but in all your ways, acknowledge Christ, and he will direct your paths. Yes. Further resolved, a copy of this resolution will be presented to the family and a copy be placed in the archives of Pilgrim Missionary Baptist Church this 23rd day of December 2023. Humbly submitted, Nora Leslie Lofton, chapter representative, Brother Douglas Pratt, assistant chapter representative, Bishop Albert L. Jameson, chairman, the late Reverend James Cleveland, founder, Sister Gloria Poole Bland, secretary. God bless you.
Amen. Amen, church.
Amen.
At this time, we have remarks from family, promoters, and other artists. And let's try to stick with the order of service, please. 2 minutes, please, in that order. Thank you.
It is a blessing, and it's an honor as well as a privilege to be able to come and speak on my friend. I'm going to try to do the 2 minutes, I'll take it. I come down here on numerous occasions, and sit down on that porch and talk with Arthur, and we talk for hours. And he would take that guitar on before he moved where he had last was living. I never get called Kevin and say, I'm here in town. I would just be in town. And we'll take that guitar and he'll try to teach me some things on that guitar. We was talking about the old years, the old times. Yeah. And I remember in 1979 to 1999, I had a radio broadcast out of San Antonio, Georgia. And I was just a boy then. My hair was jet black. And I've been a Soul Stirrer fan. I mean, what I say is a Soul Stirrer fan. And I was flipping through my Soul Stirrer records before I was happened to go on the air for the first time. Asked my wife, I said, I need a topic, a title for my radio broadcast. So I started putting out my Soul Stirs album. And I ran across one, it had Dillard on there, James Davis, Rufus, and this man, Arthur Crume. And the title of the album was The Glory by Train. And I told my wife, I got it now. It's going to be the Glory Bound Train Gospel Hour. And that song brought me on the air every Sunday morning and kept me on for 20 years. And guess who wrote that song? Arthur Crume wrote that song. And he was just a great friend to me. I admire him. I look at him as a legend. His dedication to the group, to singing, to the Soul Stirs. And I remember when I would come down and when Rufus was in the nursing home, and he came into the nursing home to see his brother Rufus, and I, on my way out, I dropped my head. He said, "What is that?" I said, "Man, I just, it bothered me." I said, "I'm known as seeing Rufus on that, you and Rufus line up on stage, but he got that bass." And he's, I said, "That just hurt me to see him that way." I said, "But it's what it is, you know." And so he called me when Rufus passed. So Rufus died. I said, "Arthur," I said, "I'm going to try to be there." And he said, "LC going to be there." I said, "LC?" He said, "LC Cook." I said, "Well, I'll be there." I said, I didn't get a chance to meet Sam. I said, "Well, I can meet his brother and take some pictures." And so I came down to Rufus' funeral. And I do want to say this too. I remember a program in Claxton, Georgia. He called me and said, "We're going to be in Claxton." This is the first time, I don't want to say it never happened, but this is the first time I have ever experienced it. In Claxton, Georgia, Luther Gamble with him, and Justin, and Leroy, and so when they sang at that big old church there, they sang. And so when they got through singing, they went in the dressing room, so of course I'm going to go back. Well, those are my favorite people. So I'm going to go back. I want to talk to them and all that kind of stuff. So while I'm back in the dressing room, all of them was undressed and almost got their other clothes back on. And somebody came to the door and called Arthur and said, "Arthur, these folks refuse to leave. He said, want some more." That's the first time. He said, "There ain't more nowhere." And I was going to peek the head, and she peeked the head out. She said, "They're not going anywhere." They said, "They want some more." And Arthur came back in the dressing room and told Leroy, Luke, and all the rest of the guys, "Hey, fellas, put your clothes back on. We got to go back out." They sung that night. The legendary world famous Soul Stirs sung that night. And I'm going to say this, and I know I'm going to say, I'm brief, God. I thought this was an honor here, Carolyn. I thought this was an honor. I thought this was an honor here. And every time I would call these guys to come sing and do a program for me, they never would turn me down. The classical program was one of the last two that I seen them in person perform. And when they left Claxton, Leroy was talking to me, and I said, "Hey, man," I said, "y'all got to come and do me a show." So a few months later, they came up to Sunnyfield and done the last show that I had to do for me. But I do want to say this, after all that retired, he called me. He said, "Real," he said, I'm gonna do a book on my life. He said, "How would you like to be in that book? How would you?" He said, "I'd like for you." I said, "Me?" He said, "Sure." He said, "I want you to do my interview." I said, "Me? I thought it was an honor." I said, "Yes, yes, yes, I'll be glad. You just let me know when I'm supposed to come down." And so he called me, and the title of that book is The Perfect Son. And I'm interviewing him in that book, Reverend Warren Harris Sr. So I invite you to go out and get that book, The Perfect Son, by Mr. Arthur Crume, okay? All right, now, when I was interviewing him, it got kind of comical, and I was asking him questions. He hit the record and cut it off. I said, "What is it, man?" He said, "You asked the wrong question." He said, "The book is not about Leroy, Sam Cook, and Jimmy Allen. It's about come down on numerous occasions to talk to this man. And I want to say, Arthur, we're going to miss you, man. But you know what, 94 years old? And I want to say this as I sit down. I won't be able to come by his house anymore. I won't be able to sit down and talk to him. I won't be able to get out on that porch and talk with him. But just maybe we'll be together on that glory bound train.
Amen. Praise God, everybody. It's an honor to be here today. First of all, the honor to be the Spirit of Christ, the pastor of this great church, to this great family. My association with the Crume family goes back a long ways. I won't go back as far as I can go. And like my brother just said a few minutes ago, I had the opportunity to interview Arthur and Leroy together on my radio show in Atlanta, Georgia. I had a show called Quartet Power, and I featured another great quartet music. And Arthur told me he had this book coming out. I told him, I said, well, make sure you call me and we'll go over that book with you when you get it out at that time. But I never did hear from him, so I was just wondering about that book. I never had a chance to see it, and I hope I can get a copy of it. But my association with the Crume family goes way back with Sam Cooke and Leroy and Brother Farley and all the rest of the soul stirrers back then. I met Brother Dillard Crume, his lovely wife, Sister Carolyn, and Ray and his family down in Orlando, Florida, spent time at their house. Brother Rufus, I know the whole family. But anyway, I'm just honored to be here today with my wife and I. My name is Clarence Connor, and this is my wife, Pastor Eva Connor. We're from Atlanta, Georgia, and we're just happy to be here today and to show our support. And there's one thing I want to leave with you before we leave. I remember the soul sister doing this great song called That's Heaven to Me. And speaking about heaven, I want to say this. There's several ways we can get to heaven. We can get to heaven without great wealth. We can get to heaven without good health. We can get to heaven without a great name. We can get to heaven without fame. There's so many things in life that we can get to heaven. There are 10,000 things in life that we can get to heaven. But we can never get to heaven without Christ.
Come on. Amen. Amen.
When we got married 20 plus years ago,
He stopped by to check on me, to make sure that he was all right.
Ahead of my life, to the pastor, wife, and all clergy, to each and every one of you. My name is Dillard Crume, and I'm Arthur's oldest child and spoilers. And I just want to take this time to thank each and every one of you for your well wishes, all the good memories you have shared with us, and most of you all, I just don't remember. I'm too old to remember right. Now, I do remember my Frankie, though. I remember that night, so I get it. I enjoyed my daddy's group as well. Every time you come to Chicago, I'm the first one to put on a little sunny dress. And Debra sit right there and don't move. I said, okay then. Then I was really, my first time seeing them, I was really, really excited because I've never seen my dad until I was about 5 or 6 years old singing. And then when the 5 black boys came past, I said, they can't see. He said, no, little girl, they're blind. That's why they call them 5 blind women. But them men, because I ain't no background back then. But on behalf of me and my siblings, a whole bunch of us, we just truly thank you for your kindness. God bless you.
Amen.
And a special thanks to my Auntie Carolyn, because you guys, I live in Chicago. And she and I, Melanie, when we worked, it was so hard. Because I came here that Sunday. I rushed down here. And I said, let me know where he is. And that's where I'll be. First it was Rayfield, then Claxton, then Valdez. Then Savannah. I said, I'm flying to Savannah. I didn't care how much it was. It's very expensive. But I flew. And I got there Sunday. And I was talking to my dad. And I said, Dad, how you doing? You know who I am? You Dillard Crume. Okay, I'll go with that. I said, but do you know who I am? My daughter. You know, he got that little country, I can't say it. And then come Monday, I told her that's not people like the way he looked. And she's like, what you mean I don't like the way he looked? So I took a picture and showed him. Auntie Curly got real nervous. And then Tuesday, we went up to see him. And Wednesday, I went back to Chicago. I couldn't take it. So here am I. You guys keep us lifted up in prayer. And I will with you as well.
Okay? Amen.
Thank you.
Amen. Since I was 18 years old.
this man here, a lot of people would say, well, he was like my father, he was like my father. Well, he was like my aunt. My father was Dillard. Dillard used to keep me straight. Arthur was quiet. I learned a lot from Arthur. When Arthur spoke fire. And fire was wisdom. I learned a lot from Arthur. This, I never thought I would be going all over the world. This man took me all over the world, out of the country. And Arthur had a way of getting his little jab to him when he wanted to say something. You know, he was always at, because between Glenn and I, we was in and out of the group. I stayed with Arthur up until 95. From 81, 82. Okay. In and out. And when I would come back, he would say, so he had his little way of getting his little jab. And when he took sick, you know, I tried to make it my business to come down and visit him. Like I said, sitting on that front porch, you know, he would sit there and we would talk and talk. I said, Bobby, you know who I am? Yeah. I said, this is George from New York. And you don't want to look like George. And I asked him, I said, Arthur, I said, you know, Frankie and I want to continue to carry on your legacy. I feel like I owe this to this man for taking me all over. So he said to me, he said, well, George, you know, Frankie, got my blessings. Go out there and make that dust. Like that. I said, okay, Arthur, but I'm truly
and God bless your family. Amen, church. Amen. Thank God for all those wonderful remarks, reminiscing on Brother Crume. Amen.
Amen.
At this time, we have a special tribute. First will be of Mr. Darrell Luster, Malico Records, Jackson, Mississippi, Mr. Sonny Brown Sr., the Brooklyn All-Stars of Brooklyn, New York, and the Soul Stir of Chicago, Illinois. And after that, it'll be the eulogy by Reverend Dr. Will White. Amen.
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 Malico Records out of Jackson, Mississippi. After that will be Mr. Sonny Brown Sr., then the Brooklyn All-Stars out of Brooklyn, New York, and the Soul Stirrer out of Chicago, Illinois, and Dr. Will White. Amen.
Letting you know that Earth had no sorrow.
sitting in August of this year when we lost my father, Reverend Spann, with hope to be with the Lord. And the same train,
all right,
if you don't know, is coming again.
Yeah.
But I don't know about you, but one day I stood on the banks of Jordan just to see the ship.
All right.
Go stay. Say, trying to stay in the 2 minutes.
I'm come again.
Yeah.
here, me and Dillard used to do together. All right, something like this here.
Oh, you stay with me. I'm not afraid to he attained a long 94 years old. 94 years old and don't take no medicine.
Yeah.
That's nobody but God. Well, give them from the text of Hebrews 9, chapter, verse 27. And as it is appointed unto man once to die. Mm-hmm. But after this come the judgment. Christ was once offered to bear the sins of men. And unto them that look for him shall he appear the second time without sin unto salvation.
Yes,
amen. Amen. But just a few moments from the subject. There is an appointment that we can't change. There is an appointment that we can't change. I think one of the ministers, you may be seated, has already said it. We all got an appointment. I don't care how good you feel. It ain't about whether you're sick. I'm talking about if you got good health and you feel good about yourself. You still have an appointment on your life. Where did that appointment come from? God put it there. He placed even these morticians got an appointment on their life. Each and every one of us got an appointment that God has placed on our life, and you can't change it. You may miss the doctor's appointment, and a lot of times we dodge the dentist's appointment. Even though our teeth be hurt, we still going to dodge the dentist. But there's an appointment that God has set on our life. And I can't change it. Can I get a witness here? But just a few moments, I'm going to leave you with this. Philippians 4, 11 and 13. The Apostle Paul, and I think about Brother Crume when I think about this. His meekness, how he's depending on God to keep him. Amen. Do you know we're going to get out of stage where we can't do nothing for ourselves? Come on, somebody. Even as I stand before you on this afternoon, this flesh is dying.
Yes.
I'm going to have to get me another house. So this house right here is decaying. I hear somebody said earlier, my hair won't always black. My hair. Well. Philippians 4 and 11 says, the Apostle Paul said, not that I speak in respect of woman, for I have learned in whatsoever state I'm in, there will to be content. That's Brother Crume. Where he was at, he learned how to let God have it. Let God fix it for him. The hymn writer, you know the hymn. What a friend we have with Jesus. But there's a verse in it that says, oh, what needs we offer before us, oh, what needs is pain we bear. Because we do not care everything to God in prayer. God is sitting there waiting on us. But can I say it's about relationship? You got to have a relationship. I can tell you about it earlier, you got to be born again. But get a witness here. You just not going to walk. Well, when I was a little boy, I was sneaking this theater to the black chair. I was kind of tall, so I had to hold the head down. I was sneaking to the theater. But guess what? You ain't not going to sneak into hell. Heaven is for prepared people. It ain't got no locks on the door. But everybody ain't going up in there. You're going to have your business fixed. You're going to have a well made up mind. I hear them saying, John 14 and verse 6, that which is flesh. The Holy Spirit will lead us, it's already here, and guide us into all truth. Well, can I share something with you? If the Holy Spirit is leading, guess what I got to do? I got to follow. A lot of times people don't want to let go of their thoughts. But if the Holy Ghost is going to lead you, you got to let him lead and you get behind. Can I get away? Well, John 14, 2 and 3. I said, I'm going to be with you long. He said, in my Father's house are many So Christ was once over to bear the sins of many, and unto them that look for him shall he appear. When he come back, he's not coming back as baby Jesus. He's coming back to serve judgment. Only those who are born again are born again. You gotta have a well-made of mind. A lot of times you're gonna have to walk by yourself. A lot of times you're gonna have to go by yourself. But we sang the song, I have decided to follow Jesus. Everybody can't go there. Sometimes you're going somebody to go with. But when I stand before the judgment,
yeah. see.